She's always been a very proud filly, and she's always carried herself in that manner. From the day she came in as a baby, you always knew she was there. She didn't slop around the place, very much alert and on her toes, always inquisitive. I mean, when this tannoy started this morning, she was a mile and a half away, she's straight away like that. And the others were saying, well, I didn't really hear it. She's very quick like that. Look, obviously she's a pleasure to train because she's so positive and willing. It's rather like when you work with someone in an office or anywhere where you work, in a factory. If you've got people beside you that are willing and givers and always try and be positive and do their best, they are a pleasure to be with. Certainly the moaning types are not where you want to be. So she has this positive mindset. As a racehorse, she's very competitive. She's learned in through life to be less exuberant in everything she does. As I think she got older, she's a little more measured, a little more, I'll save my energy for that. She's clever that way. Highly intelligent, but just with the will to win. And she's got a little bit like a boxer who now has to go have 15 rounds. She sort of sits on a horse and just holds it, rather than bursting three clear. So to that extent, she's a pleasure to train. She's very much one that you respect her, and you do what she wants. You go with her. You don't try and impose your will on her. That would not work. Well, because obviously she's very much a filly that, you know, she's captured imagination. Because I think the certain longevity helps. She only ran once at two, but she obviously won everything as a three-year-old, winning the Three Oaks, you know, English, Irish, Yorkshire, as well as winning the King George the Sixth, the older horse races, William winning the Ark. So she did everything at three. Then she sustained a minor injury, but it took quite a lot of time to get over. And then she had to come back. And she didn't just go and come back off one little run and getting sick, which is exactly this day last year she wasn't well. She then came back and won the Prix de Triomphes, then went to Churchill Downs, Kentucky, and then went ahead and won the Breeders' Cup Turf, which no horse has ever won the Ark in the Breeders' Cup Turf. So the American following for her is very strong, the Australian following, the Japanese following, as well as the UK. She's just one of those fillies who's rather done everything. You can see the way she moved up this, the way she looks. She's becoming a little bit imperious, but she's not conceited. Well, I think first of all, they don't get distracted like some of the boys can. And I think it's fair to say that testosterone is probably one of the most dangerous drugs in the world. They can, when they become great race mares, they get in a zone. And they're very, very strong of their minds. And I think they're not distracted by things. The spring of the year for them can be difficult because of hormonal changes with the light and the warmth coming and what would be their natural breeding season. I think that can be very tough on fillies. But once you get through that sort of March, April, May, and you start moving into June, July onwards, it's interesting. All of that is settled in them. And then they just tune into the racing. And I think to that extent, they can turn out to be the toughest and the strongest and the ones with the most longevity. Well, when she came in as a baby, the one thing I noticed straight away was the extraordinary ribcage, the depth of her girth area. And we call that, if you like, it's where the cardiovascular system is in the lungs. She had that attribute. She had a good length of leg, a great stride on her. Good strong hind quarters, so she's very well made. She was not going to be a precocious early type. She was always going to grow and fill into that frame. And then, of course, she has the mental strength I'm talking about. And when you put all those together, you're in business. Sadly, what happens, you have three and not five, you know, or two and not five, or four and not five, and something else stops them being what they could be. But she luckily has it all. But, you know, we have to keep her in good order and try and get her to the races. And horses, you know, she could be stepped on the stone on the way home. That's the way the game is, and have a bruised foot. You just don't know. You spend all your time on tender hooks with them.
Excellent. Well, the two horses only have just down the bottom of the
their own now. Name, I think. Yeah, they've just set that's off. Enough.